Fukushima Apocalypse. Years of duct tape fixes could result in millions of deaths. Even the tiniest mistake made during an operation to extract over 1,300 fuel rods at the crippled Fukushima nuclear power plant in Japan could lead to a series of cascading failures with an apocalyptic outcome. Fallout researcher Christina Consolo told RT, Fukushima operator TEPCO wants to extract 400 tons worth of spent fuel rods stored in a pool at the plant's damaged reactor number 4. The removal will have to be done manually and from the top floor of the damaged building on the radiation-contaminated environment. In the worst-case scenario, a mishandled rod may go critical, resulting in an above-ground meltdown releasing radioactive fallout with no way to stop it, said Consolo, who is the founder of the host of Nuked Radio. But leaving the things as they are is not an option, because of statistical risk of similarly bad outcome increases every day, she said. How serious is the fuel rod situation compared to the danger of contaminated water buildup, which we already know about? Although fuel rod removal happens on a daily basis at the 430-plus nuclear sites around the world, it is a very delicate procedure even under the best of circumstances. What makes fuel removal at Fukushima so dangerous and complex is that it will be attempted on the fuel pool whose integrity has been severely compromised. However, it must be attempted as reactor number 4 has the most significant problem structurally, and this pool is on the top floor of the building. There are numerous other reasons that this fuel will be dangerous undertaking. The racks inside the pool that contain this fuel were damaged by the explosion in the early days of the accident. Zirconium cladding, which is encased the rods, burned when the water levels dropped, but to what extent the rods have been damaged is not known, and probably won't be until removal is attempted. Salt water cooling has caused corrosion of the pool walls and probably the fuel rods and racks. The building is sinking. The cranes that normally lift the fuel were destroyed. Computer-guided removal will not be possible. Everything will have to be done manually. TEPCO cannot attempt this procedure without humans, which will manage this enormous task while being bombarded with radiation during the extraction and casking. The process of removing each rod will have to be repeated over 1,300 times without incident. Moving damaged nuclear fuel under such complex conditions could result in a criticality if fuel rods come into close proximity to one another, which would then set off a chain reaction that cannot be stopped. What could potentially happen is that the contents of the pool could burn and or explode, the entire structure sustain further damage and collapse. This chain reaction process could be self-sustaining and go for a long time. This is the apocalyptic scenario in a nutshell. The water buildup is an extremely difficult problem in and of itself, and as anyone with a leaky basement knows, water always finds a way. At Fukushima, they are dealing with massive amounts of groundwater that flow through the property, and the endless pouring that must be, and the endless pumping that must be kept up 24/7, 365 to keep things from getting worse. Recently, there appears to be subsidence issues and liquefaction under the plants. TEPCO decided to pump the water out of these buildings. However, pumping the water out of the buildings is only going to increase the flow rate and create more of those ground issues around the reactors. An enormous undertaking, but one that needs to be considered for long-term preservation of the integrity of the site, is channeling the water away, like a drain tile installed around the perimeter of a house with a leaky basement, but on an epic scale. Without this effort, the soils will further deteriorate, structural shift will occur, and subsequently contents of the pools will shift as well. And the water that flows into these buildings also becomes highly radioactive and is likely coming into contact with melted fuel. Without knowing the extent of the current liquefaction and its location, the location of the melted fuel, how long TEPCO has been pumping out water, or when the next earthquake will hit. It is impossible to predict how soon this could occur from the water problem subsidence issue alone. But undoubtedly, pumping the water out of these buildings is just encouraging the flow, and this water problem needs to be remedied and redirected as soon as possible. And the story goes on. How the entire northern hemisphere is in jeopardy. If they drop one of these bundles and it causes a chain reaction, Fukushima and several other nuclear reactors in the area could have to be abandoned due to radiation levels, and the entire north part of Japan would be uninhabitable. And they are going to start removing these fuel rods. Thanks, Christina, for all the work you do, Miss Milky the Clown, and everybody else. Enjoy while you can, everybody. Thanks.